In this video tutorial, I'm going to give you a full walkthrough and overview of how to set up your Buy Me a Coffee page and link. So this service allows you to create a link in a page, kind of similar to Patreon, where you can see this creator here allows people to either buy him a coffee, which means, you know, send him some money directly, or they can even join their page for benefits and perks. So you have the normal buy a coffee where they can buy you a coffee and send you money directly. And then you have support pages and tiers where people will subscribe monthly. So first thing you want to do is go to the URL buymeacoffee.com. It'll take you to the homepage here. And then the first thing you want to do is go to the Start My Page link that'll be in the middle of the page. Next, you'll want to create your account. So for me, it'll be buymeacoffee.com/ and then whatever you want your username to be. I'll just make mine my first and last name. And if it's available, you will see a green check mark here. Then you want to go to the yellow sign up button in the lower right hand corner, and then it will ask you to log in with one of your existing services or create an account with an email and a password. So go ahead and create by either logging in or with an email or password, and then we'll go to the next step. Now that I've logged in, I am now presented with the complete your page section of the tutorial. This means that I need to go here and give my page a name. So for me, it's going to be my name. I'm going to write a brief bio about myself, and then any website or social link that I have, I'll put my website URL here. And then you want to upload a profile photo. So go ahead and do all of these things now. All right, once you've uploaded your profile picture, given your page a name and a brief bio, as well as your social link, go ahead and click the yellow Next button in the lower right-hand corner. This will then take us to our payment method, so we have to first choose our country, so choose your country, and then go ahead and go to enter your bank info. This is very important. You have to provide Buy Me a Coffee with a way to send you money. So we go ahead and click the Add Information button here, and then it will bring up where we will connect Stripe or whatever payment processor that you use. So as you can see, I'm logging in with Stripe because that's who partners with Buy Me a Coffee. If you don't have a Stripe account, you can always go to stripe.com, connect your bank account information, log in, and then you should be able to connect Stripe directly with Buy Me a Coffee. Because if you have no way for them to send you the money, it'll just be sitting there and it's kind of wasted time. So go ahead and do that now. Once you've logged in with Stripe, it will actually pull your information from Stripe as far as your address, your full name, what country you're in, and you can either create a new business within Stripe or just pull the information directly from Stripe. So go ahead and choose which option you want to do here. I'm going to choose the information that it pulled from the payment processor, and then I'm going to go ahead and click Continue. Now again, just quickly, all you would need to do is just go over to stripe.com, as you can see here, and if you don't already have an account, which I assume you probably don't, you can go ahead and log in or go to sign in like this here. And then once you're under the sign in page, you can go to new to Stripe, create an account right here, and then you just go ahead and create an account and follow the steps just like you saw me do there. Once you do that, it will present you with a one-pager to review and submit. It will give you all the information from your business type, which you probably are an individual or a sole proprietor, and then your website details as well as personal details. And you should see, I'm graying this out obviously, but you should see your payment details under payout details. Make sure that that bank account information or card information is correct, so when you do get money, you're able to send it to that destination. So go ahead and click the Agree and Submit button at the very bottom of the page. Once you're done, you'll see a page that says information submitted. You'll see some confetti, and then it says your page is live. I can click on that there to copy it, and I can always go to a new browser tab, and I can paste it and go to my link, and here it is. You will see all of the information. Obviously, I have no recent supporters. You have the ability to change a few things here. We can add a cover image by clicking on add cover image, and then we can upload a cover image, and then we can make it be whatever we want our cover image to be. We can drag and drop that like you see me doing here if that's something that you want to do. And when you're ready, go ahead and save changes. Another thing that we can do is we can go to the upper right-hand corner and we can go to edit page, just like so. This will allow us to change our profile photo, change our name, put in what we are creating. So for me, I might say, you know, YouTube videos, podcast, things of that nature right here. And then we can arrange our sidebar. So we can arrange our sidebar right now. Currently, we'll just see the support option, but we can go and add a membership or a shop. And I'll show you how to do that here in a second. We can always add more social links. We can even put a video link from YouTube here if we want. And then we can always go here and change the currency from coffee to beer, pizza, book, whatever you want it to be. And you can change the emoji there as well. Also, a theme color for our page. I'm going to change mine to this green color here. And then if you want to, you can choose whether you display your supporter count or not. And I'll just go ahead and say that I am. And then I'll go ahead and give myself a username here for social sharing purposes, and then click the blue save button in the upper right hand corner. Now, one of the things that you can do is if we go back to edit page in the upper right hand corner, you'll see different options here that say membership and shop. If we go to the membership option and we go to set up membership here, so I will open that in a new tab, we can now enable membership. So if we enable membership, this will allow you to set up tiers like on sites like Patreon where people can go and support you. So you can give these tiers names like bronze, gold, titanium, and then you give them a price per month or a yearly price if you want to give them a discount for that. Give that tier a description, upload a cover image for that tier, and then go ahead and add rewards. So click on add reward, and then there's some templated rewards here, and then you'll see some that are custom where you can click on add and add your own custom rewards. A welcome note is going to be when they sign up for that monthly or yearly membership, it will send this to them via email. So you can preview this right here. It says, thank you for joining my membership, and then you'll get an email. You can also limit the number of members. If you say, hey, the first 10 to sign up can get, you know, $5 a month, you know, and you can limit that to say 10 members, or if you want it to be unlimited, you uncheck that. And then you can also give members access to a selected Discord server. This is very easy. Click on Connect Discord, connect it to the Discord server that you own, and you are good to go. So you can add as many levels as you want or tiers to this. And when you're ready, go to create like I'm doing here. And right here on your page, you will see like this gentleman here that we have different membership tiers right below there. And the last thing I wanted to show you is how to set up your shop where you can actually sell physical merchandise. So right here under our edit page, right here where it says shop, go ahead and click the setup shop option here. And this is where we can choose from a digital product, a physical good, or we can start from scratch. We'll go ahead and say this is a physical good. Just like listing things on eBay or Amazon, you'll have to give the item a name, description, images are always good, a price, and then success page, I'd leave that to confirmation. And then you can always add new categories if there will be multiple categories. And if you go back here to one of the already set up things here, you can see under shop, there are things that people can buy if we click on them, add them to a cart. And just like that, you have a shop page here where people can buy goods and digital goods from you directly from your Buy Me a Coffee page. If this was helpful, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe, and I will see you guys in the next video.